What's up, guys? Dylan here, and welcome back to Advent of Code 2020, day three in Python. We're going to go ahead and get to the solutions for day three, and if you find them helpful, please drop a like down below. So let's get into it. So let's open up today. We're going to see, so toboggan problems resolved. We can make our way to the airport, but it's not safe. There are trees. Making coordinates on a grid. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay, so it looks like we're going to be navigating through this grid of trees. Pattern repeats. And starting on the open square in the top left, we're going to make our way to the bottom of the map, going right three and down one. Okay, so it looks like, so it shows us. So if we go right three, down one, you can see here in the corresponding spot, there's no tree. Right through down one again, there is a tree, so they have an X. So we're gonna count how many trees we would encounter if we go down one. Okay, so we're just gonna right through down one, right through down one, right through down one, right through down one until we get to the end, counting how many trees we encounter, where the trees are the hashes. Okay, let's get our input for today, and it looks like, let's take a look at this. So it looks like we're gonna reach a side way before we get to the bottom. So I'm guessing we're going to be going like this, where we wrap back around to the beginning. So we're going to try that and see how well it works. So I'm going to go ahead and copy the inputs, make a new file, paste it in, and save. And let's get going. So first thing we are going to do is we are going to declare with open input 3.txt as a file, and then we will say our map is going to be equal to file.readline, so we'll get all those in, and just checking if we print our map, then okay, we have all the new line characters, so let's get rid of that. So we're just going to say map is equal to new list, which is going to be one dot strip for, can't type today, for line in map. So this is just going to remove all the new line characters, and if we run that again, okay, we've gotten rid of all the new line characters, and so now we are just going to say tree count is equal to zero, so we'll count up how many trees we find. And well, we're gonna need to know the row that we're in and the column that we're in, starting at the top left. So that's, so we start at 0, 0, and then while row, because we're moving downwards, while row is less than, yes, while row is less than map, the length of the map, so that's basically, so the length of the map is representative of how many rows there are, and plus one, so we don't get an out of bounds. Basically, this row plus one, because we're gonna add here, so row, we're gonna add one each time, and column, we're going to add three each time, because we're moving right three, down one. And because we're adding this one, we want to make sure we stop before we go out of bounds. And then let's go ahead and say, well, let's just check. So the space that we're going to be checking is going to be equal to map row to get the row that we're in, and then the column. But eventually the column will be out of bounds. But we, like I said, we can wrap back around. How would we? I guess if we mod it by the size of the, by the length of map row. So that way we will always be in bounds because this will be because the mod will be either from 0 to 1 minus the length of the row. And then if space is equal to a tree, then tree count is going to increment by 1. And print tree count. And let's hope it runs. First try, we have an error. What is wrong? Invalid syntax. And 289. Let's go ahead and try it. All right, there we have part one. Let's go on to part two. The time to check the rest of the slopes. You need to minimize the probability of a sudden arboreal stop. Determine the number of trees you would encounter for all the following slopes. So right one, down one. Okay, we've already done that one. And what do you get if you multiply the number of trees encountered on each of the listed slopes? So we're just gonna get the number, the tree count for each of these and multiply them all together. So I think I have an idea of how to do this. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy all this. But we're gonna start by saying, well, here we have part two. So we're gonna say the slopes, and we can make these a list of tuples. So we're gonna move right one, down one, right three, down one, right five, down one, right seven, down one, and right one, down two. So basically what we're gonna do is for each of these slope combinations, we're gonna do this process a bunch of times. So just basically once for each of these. So we can say the total, and we're gonna be multiplying instead of adding. So we're gonna make that equal to one, and then let's go ahead and bring that over a tad, and then we'll say for slope and slopes. So we're just gonna do each of these tuples. Tree count is equal to 0. Yes, so reset these each time. And then instead of incrementing that, we're just gonna take slope, and this is the up and down value, so we'll take slope one. So the slope one, this will basically take this tuple and give us the second value here, and then slope 0 to get that value there. Tree count equals one, and then once we're done finding the tree count for the slope, we will just say total. It's like plus equals, but with multiplication. And tree count. And then we will print total down here at the bottom. And holy cow, that is a big number. That's a lot of trees. So there you have it. Advent of Code 2020, day 2 in Python. If you found the solution helpful, please drop a like down below, and I'll see you tomorrow for day 4.